Before the news, we got industry reaction to the government's announcement that it's allowing up to 2,000 experienced seasonal workers from the Pacific into New Zealand to help with upcoming harvests. The Kiwi Fruit Growers Chief Executive saying it's a good start. Joining us now from Wellington to explain what drove the government's decision and the reasons for the limits around the scheme is Immigration Minister Kris Faafoi. Good morning, Minister. We've been hearing this for months. The industry's been crying out for more workers. So what took so long?
Oh, we've got to get the balance right. Obviously, these workers have to come through managed isolation, and driving all of this too is that we want to make sure that we prioritise New Zealand workers getting into that job. COVID-19 has obviously posed some challenges with New Zealanders being able to stay in work or get enough work, so we're working with the sector to make sure that they can prioritise some of this labour gap that they've got at the moment with Kiwi workers. But obviously, there is going to be a shortfall, which is why we've agreed to 2,000 workers from mid-January, as you say. And again, there's many things to balance in that, and chief amongst that, keeping safe and making sure New Zealanders can work.
It does feel like a real balancing act. So what were the kind of factors that went into that?
Look, those two factors there, but also the capacity of managed isolation facilities. New Zealanders always have the right to come home, which is why we didn't want to back that up with those who are coming home for the likes of Christmas and New Year's. So mid-January, we think we'll work to get those workers here in time for harvest. We'll stagger them so they won't all arrive at the same time to ensure that, again, Kiwis who want to come home can do that. And if we need to bring others in for any other reason, there's still some capacity to do that through our managed isolation facilities.
Who decides how these workers are going to get split? Because obviously 2,000 workers, but different crops everywhere. Are you envisaging that they'll be moving around from crop to crop?
Yeah, we want the sector to lead in and lean in there as well. We're very much relying on them. Part of the conditions around the 2,000 workers coming in is that they have to cooperate with some flexibility of the workers. You had Nikki on just before the news, and she was saying their harvest doesn't really start till a little bit later. The apples might start a little bit earlier. So again, different parts of the sector saying, OK, we can utilise these workers at this time and looking after kiwifruit later in the year. And then, as you said, wine, looking at it June-ish for pruning. And again, they will have to have a relatively complex game of Tetris to make sure that that can all work.
So they will still be a little bit short, won't they, the industry?
Yeah, that's right, and that's why we'll continue to work with them, primarily to make sure that New Zealanders can be the first point of call for that shortfall. We know that we want to make sure as much of that crop can get harvested. It's a $6.5 billion market for New Zealand, and 40,000 jobs, around 40,000 jobs rely on it. So maximising that is important. So again, if we can have as close a harvest to as what is a normal harvest, that'll be good for New Zealand.
The seasonal workers are going to be paid $22.10 an hour. I understand that maybe the local workers are less. Do you see some implications on that on the industry?
Look, yes. Obviously, these workers are experienced. They're not going to be new RSE workers. So, as Nikki said, the productivity of these workers, we think, needs to be compensated with that rate. And we know from the conversations that we've had with some parts of the sector in some regions that they're quite willing to pay $22.10 across the board in order to make sure that they can fill those places with New Zealanders. So there is still a challenge to fill some of that capacity that they'll need to get the pick harvested. But as Nikki said, we're pretty confident if we continue to keep talking to each other, watching what the labour supply is doing, that we can get to a point where everyone's happy.
Could there be a point where you have to say, OK, we've got to let in another number here?
Look, we'd hope that we wouldn't need to do that. Again, New Zealanders to take some of those jobs first. We're trying everything we can do to support that. But again, we've committed to keep continuing to have conversations with them on a very regular basis to be able to make sure we can do that. There's a flip side of that too. Allowing 2,000 workers in is not obviously not as many as we would normally bring in. There's still 6,000 here from the previous harvest. But importantly also, these people who are coming to New Zealand from the Pacific are sending a lot of that money home to support their families, and those economies are doing it a bit tough at the moment.
Yeah, that's
too.
Right. And also, there's been no decision, as Nikki mentioned, no decision on which countries can participate. So is there enough time to work out the agreements?
Yeah, we believe so. As I mentioned before, there's still 6,000 here from the previous harvest. Most of them want to be here. Some of them would have preferred to have gone home, but their countries have closed their borders too. So a key part of this for the countries who might want to open up their workers coming to New Zealand will be the understanding that those workers that are still here will be able to return to to their countries too. So we're going through those conversations as we speak, and hopefully we'll be able to fill that gap of knowledge for the sector soon so they know exactly who will be coming.
Safety, you've already mentioned it, but there is quite a duty of care to these workers coming in, isn't there?
Yeah, and the usual conditions upon that, as well as paying them the wage that you mentioned before. We'll be watching closely that the likes of accommodation and the pastoral care is being done. To be honest, the growers who will be taking part in this scheme will already have met that mark, so we're pretty confident that they'll be looking after these workers, and if there's any issues, we'll keep in close contact with the growers themselves.
Immigration Minister Kris Faafoi, thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.